Hello, stranger. I don't suppose you know anyone that can make traps. Old Man Barlin said that Darkspawn may be coming soon. He's got traps on his farm. I figured I'd put a few on my lands. Barlin wants to poison his traps. I just want normal traps. None to be had. Barlin has all the traps in the village in his fields. Oh, he doesn't have any poison yet, thank the Maker. So his fields are just full of traps. He can be a bit eccentric. I didn't mean to bother you. Sorry.
You got a bed for the night? You taken care of? Ever since good King Caelan passed, refugees... I'm the elder here, and I've my hands full making sure refugees don't turn to petty theft, or worse. Sir Bryant at the Chantry has seen to matters of defence and such. He'd have more of an ear for your type. Too much to do, and not enough time. I don't suppose you know anything of tonics, medicines, or herbs. Then you may be able to do us a lot of good. All manner of travellers come through, many injured or sick. We do our best, but we're out of supplies. There's medicinal herbs in the woods to the north. If you make a few poultices, I'll scrape together some sort of payment. I'll write all you need to know in this note here.
You accuse me of thievery.
I saw you take the supplies from my car.
The carnage we left in the wilds was horrifying.
You marsh folk are all thieves and liars.
In the wilds we are
eating. Enough.
Here we
starve. People here are already
desperate
and frightened.
Is there no end to our fortune?
Shokte Vasitisra. You aren't one of my captors. I have nothing to say that would amuse you, elf. Leave me in peace. I'm in a cage, am I not? I've been placed here by the Chantry.
The revered mother said he slaughtered an entire family, even the children.
It is as she says. I am Sten of the Beresad, the vanguard of the Kunari peoples. You mock me, or you show manners I have not come to expect in your lands. Though it matters little now, I will die soon enough.
This is a proud and powerful creature, trapped as prey for the Darkspawn. If you cannot see a use for him, I suggest releasing him for mercy's sake alone.
Mercy? I wouldn't have expected that from you.
I would also suggest that Alistair take his place in the cage.
Yes, that's what I would have expected.
I suggest you leave me to my fate. Tempting, but I shall decline. Were you in my position, would you prolong your imprisonment? My preference is death and battle. Failing that, I will wait for the Darkspawn. No doubt. What help do you seek? The Blight. Are you a Grey Warden, then? Surprising. My people have heard legends of the Grey Warden's strength and skill. Though I suppose not every legend is true. Perhaps if you told her the Grey Wardens need my assistance, it seems as likely to bring my death as waiting here. Farewell, then.
To be left here to starve, or to be taken by the Darkspawn? No one deserves that. Not even a murderer.
I said enough!
be done. I shall do it.
Done heard what was said. You're a warden. I don't know if you killed King Kaelin, and make her forgive me, I don't care. But that bounty on your head could feed a lot of hungry bellies. Attack!
Enemies approaching!
Very well. It is begun.
Headed.
Allow me.
It is begun.
I could do that for you. As you like.
Someone help us!
Mighty timely arrival there, my friend. I'm much obliged. The name's Bodon Fedic, merchant and entrepreneur. This here is my son, Sandal. Say hello, my boy.
Hello.
Road's been mighty dangerous these days. Mind if I ask what brings you out here? Perhaps we're going the same way. Grey Wardens. My, that does rather explain a lot. No offence, but I suspect there's more excitement on your path than my boy and I can handle. Allow me to bid you farewell and good fortune, though.
Goodbye.
Now then, let's get this mess cleaned up, shall we?
It shall be done.
Thank you.
Allow me.
I could do that for you.
Speak to that knight yesterday. Said he was from Redcliffe.
He talked to everyone in the tavern. How are we supposed to know where the Urn of Sacred Ashes is? Might as well ask us how to get to the moon.
I have a wonder, Alistair, if you will indulge me.
Do I have a choice?
Blessed are the peacekeepers, champions of the just.
Allow me.
I could do that for you.
I hear those bandits are back again. Why don't the Templars kill them?
Have any luck finding herbs in the woods? This will help many people. You're a good sort, you know.
Some fellow in the tavern said that the darkspawn turned folks into ghouls.
What's a ghoul?
Good day, Sister Liliana. I'm surprised to see you're still in Lothering.
It is good to see you as well, Your Reverence.
Is there something I can do for you, then? It might have been kinder to execute him, but I leave his fate to the Maker. Why does he interest you? Then his next victims might count you and me as their murderers. And what do you say on this, Liliana? You know your friend better than I.
These are unusual times, Your Reverence. With us, the Kunari might do some good. I am sure of it, in fact.
Were things not so desperate? Very well, I trust you. Take these keys to his cage and make her watch over you.
Thank you, Your Reverence. Your trust is not misplaced.
So, let me get this straight. You were a cloistered sister?
You must have been a brother before you became a Templar, no?
I never actually became a Templar.
You wish something more of me? I confess, I did not think the priestess would part with it. So be it. Set me free and I will follow you against the Blight. Is done. I will follow you into battle. In doing so, I shall find my atonement. May we proceed. I am eager to be elsewhere.
Back, are you? I thought we settled things nice and amicably with you wardens. Well, we don't want trouble, so yes, we'll do that. Thank you for sparing us.
But you said these refugee types was easy pickings.
There are better pastures elsewhere, you fool. Time to go. Thank you.
this?
The path of righteousness is full of hardship, but the Maker smiles upon its travelers. And the stars stood still, the winds did quiet, and all animals of earth and air held their breath. All was silent in prayer and thanks.
Bad dreams, huh? Drag more like, as in the tainted blood, remember? You see, part of being a Grey Warden is being able to hear the Darkspawn. That's what your dream was, hearing them. The Archdemon, it talks to the Horde, and we feel it just as they do. That's why we know this is really a blight. I don't know if it's really a dragon, but it sure looks like one. But yes, that's the Archdemon. It takes a bit, but eventually you can block the dreams out. Some of the older Grey Wardens say they can understand the Archdemon a bit, but I sure can't. Anyhow, when I heard you thrashing around, I thought I should tell you. It was scary at first for me, too. Other than dying young and the whole defeat the Blight alone thing, no, I'm all tapped out for surprises. Anyhow, you're up now, right? Let's pull up camp and get a move on.
Man to find. Where are my manners? The name is Levy. Levy Dryden. Did Duncan ever mention me? Levy of the coins? Levy the trader? Really? He never told you of old Levy? We've known each other for years. But here I am carrying on while you have a blight to stop. Don't want to waste your time. But you see, Duncan promised that together we'd look into something important for the Wardens. And for me, but poor Duncan's, well, no more. A tragedy it is, at that. But I know he would want his work carried on, his pledge fulfilled. My family, well, past a bit checkered to see. Nobles look at us with disdain. My great-great-grandmother, Sophia Dryden, was the last Warden Commander of Ferelden back when the Wardens were known as Freeloaders. So King Arlan banished the Wardens, and he took House Dryden's land and titles. Hard to say. After King Arlan died, there was a civil war, loads worse than this one. And our family was on the run, hunted by enemies, with nary a friend in the world. But Drydens are tough. We rebuilt, became merchants, and we never lost our pride. Our family's only crime was guarding the kingdom against the Blight. We're not ashamed of that. I ask for the truth. My family reveres Sophia Dryden. We know she died at the old Grey Warden base, Soldier's Peak. We want evidence to clear her name. It won't restore our land or our titles, but it'll restore our honour. Well, no one's been to Soldier's Peak since Arlan's days. At least none that's come back. I spent years mapping the maze of tunnels to the peak, and I found the way a few years back. So I went to Duncan, I did, and I said that he could reclaim the old base and my family could have its honour. I can pick my way through the tunnels at the base of Soldier's Peak, but the place, well, they say it's haunted. And it'll be dangerous for certain. Will you think on it, at least? 1,000 blessings upon you, Warden. I'll mark down the location on your map. When you arrive, we'll pick our way through the tunnels together.
Ah, it's good to see you, my timely rescuer. Bodon Fenix. At your service, once again. I saw your camp and thought to myself, what safer place to rest for the evening than in the camp of a Grey Warden? I'm perfectly willing to offer you a fine discount for the inconvenience of our presence,
How does that sound? Good? Yes? I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
Hello.
The boy's a bit simple, but he's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a... what was it now? A savant. I had no idea such a thing existed.
Enchantment!
Shall be done.
Blast and damnation, indeed.
Yes.
Hold, outsider. You may be of my kind, but you are not Dalish. Why are you here? And what business is that? That is not a lie that many would attempt. I will bring you to the Keeper then, and he can decide if your business is worthwhile.
I see we have guests. Who are these strangers, Mithra? I have precious little patience and less time to spend on outsiders today.
This one claims to be a Grey Warden and wishes to speak with the clan. I thought it best to leave the decision to you.
That was wise of you. Masirinus, Mithra, you may return to your post.
Manuvenin, Keeper.
Now, allow me to introduce myself. I am Zathrian, the keeper of this clan, its guide and preserver of our ancient lore. And you are? If you came to bring news of the Blight in the south, it is not needed. I had already sensed its corruption. I would have taken the clan north by now, had we the ability to move. Sadly, as you can see, we do not.
Yes, it seems like you've had your own troubles. What are the odds?
I imagine you are here regarding the treaty we signed centuries ago. Unfortunately, we may not be able to live up to the promise we made. This will require some explanation. Please, follow me. The clan came to the Brazilian forest 1 month ago, as is our custom when we enter this part of Ferelden. We are always wary of the dangers in the forest, but we did not expect the werewolves would be lying in wait for us. They ambushed us, and though we drove the beasts back, much damage was done. Many of our warriors lie dying as we speak, even with all our magic and healing skill. We will eventually be forced to slay our brethren to prevent them from becoming beasts. The Blight's evil must be stopped. But we are in no position to uphold our obligations. I am truly sorry. The affliction is a curse that runs rampant in their blood, bringing great agony and then ultimately either death or a transformation into something monstrous. The only thing that could help them must come from the source of the curse itself. And that would be no trivial task to retrieve. Within the Brazilian forest dwells a great wolf. We call him Witherfang. It was within him that the curse originated, and through his blood that it has been spread. If he is killed and his heart brought to me, perhaps I could destroy the curse. But this task has proven too dangerous for us. I sent some hunters into the forest a week ago, but they have not returned. I cannot risk any more of my clan. I must warn you that more than werewolves lurk in the Brazilian forest. It has a history full of carnage and murder, you see. Where there is so much death, the veil separating the spirit realm from our own becomes thin, allowing spirits to possess things, living or dead. But if you can indeed help, then I wish you luck. Then I suggest you see Master Verathorn. I will instruct him to put aside some supplies for you, the kind that the hunters use. Make them quick, if you please. I have much to do here. My apprentice Lanaya, or Sayrel, the clan's storyteller, could provide you with answers just as easily. I must return to caring for my people. Creator's speed on your way.
Leave that be. If you have need of equipment, I am sure Master Verathorn can help you. Masirinus.
Hello? I am Kamen, a hunter apprentice. Though I wish I could become a real hunter. Never mind. Just go away and leave me alone. I told you to leave me alone. I shouldn't be talking about this to an outsider. You wouldn't understand. I suppose there's no harm in it. It's not like you can help me. I've been an apprentice for too long. To become a true hunter, I must bring back the pelt of a beast I killed myself. A boar or a wolf or something. I wanted to hunt in the forest, but we're forbidden to enter because of the attack. But the real problem is Gaina. She's my heart's desire. I have asked for her hand, but she cruelly refuses it. She will not bond with an apprentice, she says, and calls me a child. I am no child. If I was a hunter, I could prove it, but I cannot hunt, and Gaina will never bond with me. I feel so helpless. I shouldn't have brought it up. Just leave me to my misery. You think I haven't thought about this? There's nothing I can do. No, I couldn't do that. I must kill the beast myself. It is my rite of passage to become a full hunter. I suppose you could, but what good would that do? The situation hasn't changed. But the keeper said, no, I just can't. What if I encountered a werewolf? I couldn't defeat one of those on my own. The keeper would know right away if I left camp. Masiranis for the offer, however. That's very kind of you. Wooing? I don't understand. I've serenaded her, and we've talked many times under the moon. But that doesn't matter if I'm still an apprentice. Not to her. Gift? No, that wouldn't be appropriate. Not before we're married. I've serenaded her, and we've talked many times under the moon. But that doesn't matter if I'm still an apprentice. Not to her. Because I love her. I really do. I wouldn't expect you to understand. Such as? All right. I'm not going anywhere anyhow. There is nothing more for us to speak of. Go away. No. Leave me be.
Andera Natishan, stranger. I am Athras. I hope the others have not been too harsh in their treatment of you.
I would be the same in their place. They have just been attacked, after all.
It is not our intention to insult a Grey Warden. We are simply wrapped up in the plight of our hunters. It is easy to forget simple niceties at such a time. I understand you will search for the wolves in the Brazilian forest. I would join you, but Zathrian has forbidden me. None of us are happy about this situation, and I least of all. But I shouldn't trouble you with this. You have your own concerns, I am certain. Well, perhaps you could help me with it. I would certainly appreciate anything you could do. My wife Denyla and I both fought the werewolves in the ambush. She was injured so gravely, the curse spread rapidly in her. Zathrian fought hard to ease her pain, but there was little he could do. And though he says that Denyla is dead, he will not let me see her body. I am beginning to believe she became a werewolf, and that it is being kept from me so I do not go chasing after her. If I could just know if Denyla is alive or what happened to her, then I could be at peace. I have an amulet made by our craftsmen. It's not much, but I would be happy to give it to you in return for any news.
What are you doing? You've warped the wood completely. Did you leave it out in the rain?
No, Master Ferrothorn. I think I just used too much heat.
You're not smelting ore like a Durgenlin. This is living wood. It requires patience and delicate hands, not more heat.
My actions bring me sorrow, Master Ferrothorn.
And so they should. Truly, the art will be lost to us forever at this rate. Throw away your dead wood and start anew, and I shall speak to our guest. Now then, please forgive my distraction, stranger. Is there something that you need? Yes, yes, the keeper sent word that you might ask me for such.
I took the liberty of assembling some goods that our hunters use. There is a large chest by the Aeroville where I put everything we could spare. Feel free to sort through it and take whatever you need. I have nothing left that the clan could spare, but we do have goods that we were going to bring to the Shemlin villages to barter with. I am no merchant, but let us trade. Perhaps there's something here which will be of value to you.
Darren Atishan, outsider. You spoke to him? What did he say? Oh. I don't expect an outsider to understand our ways, but I just can't bond with Kamen. He's been a hunter apprentice for over 2 years now, and he's yet to slay a proper beast. Each time he's tried, something has gone wrong. Perhaps the creators do not wish us to bond. I cannot bond with an apprentice hunter, can I? But what if he never becomes a proper hunter? What will become of our family? Oh, you are right. I have made poor Kamen miserable. No wonder he cannot complete his hunt. Masirinas, thank you. You have helped me put this into perspective. I will go and speak to Kamen. Kamen, I have been a fool.
Gaina? What do you mean? Have you changed your mind?
I have. The outsider has helped me to see that I was wrong. I have made you miserable, and I should not have.
But what about my hunt?
I don't care about that. I know you will pass your hunt in time, and we will be happy. Us and our children.
Thank you, Gaina. You've made me a happy man. I feel blessed by the gods today. We are both very grateful for the part you've played in bringing us together.
How marvelous you are. I am so happy.
This is so wonderful. Young love allowed to flourish.
Does anyone else feel the urge to vomit? No? 'Tis just me?
Here, take this. It's been in my family for a very long time, but I hope it plays some part in your battle against the Darkspawn. It's the very least we could do.
Oh, I beg your pardon, stranger. I was so busy attending to the Hala, I did not hear your approach. My name is Alora. I am the master herder in charge of caring for the Hala. Not as exciting as being a Grey Warden, but the Hala are vital to us. They are the noble beasts that pull our Aeroville, what humans call landships.
They are our companions and our guides. That is exactly what they are, in fact. We ride the Hala, but never with reins or a saddle. It is the Hala who decide where to lead us, and our privilege that they take our Aravel with them. In return, it's the herder's job to speak to the Hala and care for their needs. It's a bond of friendship, and not servitude. I fear she may have been bitten during the werewolf attack. I have tried speaking with her, but she is too agitated for me to understand. The curse would not affect her as it would us, but it would still be lethal. And it may prove contagious to the other Hala as well. I can find no wound on her, but if she's truly ill, then... Then I will have to put her out of her misery, for her sake as well as that of the others. I don't know. Do you have any skills that might help her? If you do, I would be grateful. No. No, I'm sorry. She isn't calming any more around you than she is for me. And? What do you think? I am glad you attempted it, regardless. No. That would not be right. When the time comes, then... I will do it myself. It is my duty, as both Master Herder and as her friend. She shall take her last breath, knowing she was always safest in my care.
It is begun.
Allow me. I could do that for you.
What do you wish? I'm the clan's craftsmaster. It's my responsibility to learn what I can of the ancient elven arts of shaping wood and ore. In truth, we Dalish know little of the art compared to what we once did. And even what we know has taken us many lifetimes to achieve. There is wood that, if treated properly, is as hard as steel, but far lighter. It grows only in this forest. Ironbark. The keeper has forbidden us from entering the forest to collect the wood. This means I cannot make our finest crafts for years to come. I would be hesitant to ask it of you, but if you should come across ironbark, I suppose there would be no harm in gathering some. It is blue and very distinctive. You can only harvest the bark which has fallen off the tree from age. Now, if you find some, bring it to me, and I will craft it for you. That would please me, so long as our hunters come first. Garth Shiro, may the creators visit fortune upon you.
The veil thin here, and all manner of strange things may be seen.
Wolves have spoken truly, my brothers and sisters. Another of the Dalish come to put us in our place, come to make us pay for our attack. It makes no difference to us. One elf is as good as another. Especially when they are dead. You speak to Swift Runner. I lead my cursed brothers and sisters. Turn back now. Go back to the Dalish and tell them that you have failed. Tell them we will gladly watch them suffer the same curse we have suffered for too long. We will watch them pay. You think we would help you find the Great Wolf? You think we would let you kill him? Then you are a fool. Hey, come, brothers and sisters! Swift Runner calls you to battle! Drive this invader from our midst! Enough! The forest has eyes of its own, and it shall deal with you. You have been warned.